Hi, this is Junjie from Microsoft Research Asia. I'm a senior research SDE in the machine learning group. My research work has been focused on game AI with deep reinforcement learning. This covers distributed system, machine learning, and AI capability infused gaming. Mahjong is a very popular tile-based table game with over 90 million players all over the world. Even in the United States, the National Mahjong League has over 500k members. Mahjong has 136 tiles. Players cannot see the hidden tiles of other players, and cannot see the hidden tiles in the wall either. The permutation of these hidden tiles lead to a huge number of hidden stairs. If you compare games according to a number of hidden stairs, Mahjong is much more complicated than Go and Poker. Moreover, different permutations of these hidden tiles means different levels of luck to players, and sometimes luck may dominate result. This is why Mahjong is so fascinating because it's closer to real-world applications. For example, in the financial market, the black swan event also brings uncertainties and luck to some people, and the other trader strategies are part of the hidden information. The huge state space, together with the rich hidden information, bring huge uncertainties and make it extremely difficult for AI to discover the logical links between the small set of public information and the optimal playing strategy. But once successful, it could harness AI with new capabilities that its predecessors never had. Our team at Microsoft Research Asia was very interested to explore this strategy, and we therefore decided to tackle imperfect information games using Mahjong AI. Due to Mahjong's unique challenges, previously developed algorithms for Go and Poker would not work any longer, and with new technologies. In the past several years, we have developed a novel system called Sufix. It is based on deep reinforcement learning plus cell play, and on top of that, global reward predictor, auto guiding, and the policy adaptation are the key technologies. With reinforcement learning, we can build a strong Mahjong AI even without good Mahjong skills ourselves. To evaluate Sufix performance, we got on board Tianhong, which is the most famous Mahjong platform in Japan. After playing over 5,000 games in the expert room, which is the only room AI is allowed to play in, Sufix successfully achieved 10 dan, the highest level in that room. If we look at the stable ranking, which is an index provided by Tianhong to evaluate the performance of Mahjong players, Sufix is much more stronger than top human players. This is Sufix's decision flaw in Mahjong. We can see that the rules in Mahjong are complicated. The playing order is not fixed and can be easily interrupted by chopping kong or winning. Besides the complicated rules, Mahjong contains different kinds of information. For example, tile set, tile sequence, integer information, and categorical information. How can we design the state representation that our model can better understand Mahjong's complicated rules and state? To make our model better understand Mahjong's state, we design channel-based features. It encodes all observable information into multiple channels. Take the private hand tiles as an example. It uses four channels to represent these private hand tiles. Besides the private hand tiles, we also do a short-term search and summarize the root care features. This can help our model better doing score calculation and planning. We train the model with supervised learning by expert data from Tianhong. The accuracy of our model significantly outperform existing work on Mahjong action prediction. Sufix is first trained with supervised learning and then boosted through reinforcement learning. We build a highly parallel and scalable distributed reinforcement learning system. It can support up to 70 GPUs for parallel training and more than 2.5 million of cell play games per day. To ensure reproducibility, we also build scripts for job submission, resource allocation, model and log management.
Let's talk about global reward predictor. In Mahjong, there are both run scores and game reward. Run score is determined by the winning hand of each round, and the game reward is determined by the final rank of accumulated run scores. However, the game reward cannot differentiate between the well-played runs and the poorly played runs. The run score is not well aligned with the final game reward. So, we designed a global reward predictor to provide immediate reward for each round while optimizing for long-term game reward. The input for the reward predictor is the score information of current K1s, dealer, and other related information. The output is the final game reward. The training signal for reinforcement learning is the marginal reward, which is the difference of predicted reward between the K and the K-1 runs. Next, let me introduce the oracle guiding. Oracle guiding uses an engine that can see the perfect information during sale play. The perfect information includes private hand tiles or other players, the wall tiles. It first uses all perfect information to sale play and gradually dropping out to normal features. After dropping out to normal features, it continues training with 1/10 of learning rate and rejects some state action pairs if the important ratio is larger than a threshold. With oracle guiding, we can achieve surface performance much faster. Last, let's talk about policy adaption. In Mahjong, different permutations of hidden tiles actually correspond to totally different games. What we do during offline training is to find an AI model that can perform well on many different games. However, one size fits all is always difficult. On the other hand, during online playing stage, we are dealing with one specific game in which the permutation of the hidden tile is fixed, although invisible. In this case, the real state space swings a lot and it should be easier to adapt our AI model to this specific game. Traditional methods like Monte Carlo tree search cannot be directly applied to Mahjong due to a huge number of rollout branches and irregular playing order. In surface, we take a very different approach. It adapts the offline train policy to a given initial hand as follows. First is simulation. We sample many permutations of the hidden wall tiles. Each permutation of the wall tile has the same initial hand tiles as my real initial hand tiles. We use these wall tiles to sale play and get reward signals. After simulation, we use the trajectories and rewards to fine-tune the policy, and then use the fine-tune policy to play this round. By doing so, we can expect that the offline train policy can better adapt to current score and the initial hand tiles. To demonstrate the value of each component in Suffix, we train several agents. SLO is a supervised learning model. ILO Basic uses the run score as a reward. ILO 1 uses the global reward predictor as a reward. ILO 2 further uses oracle guiding during reinforcement learning. From the figure, we can see that both global reward predictor and oracle guiding can significantly improve the performance of our models. In addition to testing the enhancement of the offline reinforcement learning, we also tested the online policy adaptation. The result shows that about 66% of the initial hand tile can get improved with policy adaptation. Finally, we provide more resources for surface. First is our paper, which is currently public on archive. Second is the game replays of surface. Third is a search link that represents more articles and news for surface. Finally, if you can read Japanese, please check out the book called Surface Impact, which is the bestseller Mahjong tactical book written by one of Japan's highest ranking players. Thank you, and feel free to contact us for any questions.
We have to actually rethink the entire AI stack.
What is reinforcement learning? Let's look at an interactive demo.
All our code is now open source.